What's up, you guys? I'm here with Jake the Toilet Snake.
Hello.
We're gonna go get some lunch, then we're gonna start the day.
We've done stuff before lunch, just to let you know.
We're not just lazy people. We have got some stuff accomplished, but we're gonna get more stuff accomplished after we eat. Because food is good.
Food is energy.
Say hi to the viewers, Jake the Toilet Snake.
How are we doing, viewers?
Jake and I were eating lunch, and then I spotted this beauty. That's perfect. Oh my goodness, it even spins. We totally need that. Treasure. We found some treasure, Jake. Let's load it up in the old Sonoma.
Wow, this is great. Great.
You'd pay good money for that. That's like a $75 bill right there.
$75?
Yeah, that's what they sell them for. They're just nicer and they got cooler stuff on them. That one's kind of boring.
How are we doing, YouTube? So today is a great day.
Because he's with 3D Machines.
Yep.
We came to value. Jake the Toilet Snake's with me. He's a professional. He hooked us right up. Not even on the clock. Getting paid.
No, just whoop, wrong button.
That's neutral. Yep.
So now we're heading back. We got our parts. Let's try to fix something, and hopefully we don't have to come back. Right, Jake the Toilet Snake?
I will be back to value at 4 o'clock back to work there. Dalton, on the other hand, hopefully not.
Our last trip, sadly, was not our last trip. Thanks to Jake the Toilet Snake. Jake had to go to work. Unfortunately, we didn't have enough time to make this video. I really wanted Jake to participate in this one. You know, that's just how life works. So as you guys know, we have a problem. Well, maybe not a problem, but more of a situation with this front tire. It's got a leak in it. So I thought this would be the perfect opportunity to test a plug. Will a plug last in a drift car? Now on this car, as you guys know, the differential is welded. So what that means is when I go around a turn, both tires spin at the same time. In all instances, the tires spin at the same speed, whether I'm going straight, turning slightly, or turning completely. So when I turn on my driveway, you always hear squeals. Or if I make too tight of a turn, you hear squeals. So a plug on a regular vehicle doesn't usually have to go through that much strain, I guess. That was easy. So the test for the day, will this plug last in a drift car? And if so, how long? I'm going to slam a lot of PSI in this tire so that we can find all the holes, if there are more than one. But I do see one big hole right in the middle of the tire. Now this tire can hold 50 PSI. We'll take it up to about 42, 45, and then we'll get some soapy water and find some holes. We're at 47 pounds. Well, right off the bat, I'm kind of stunned. I could have swore that I saw a hole here, but I don't see a single bubble on top of the tire. So where is this thing leaking from? The bead? No? This side? No? I've never been so confused. I've squirted this entire tire down, not a single bubble being produced anywhere. Like what? the objective of this video has changed. I am no longer going to test a tire plug. Instead, I'm going to do a different test. You gotta love having an emergency brake. And an air gun. Instead of testing a tire plug, I think it would be appropriate to test, well, you know when something's welded? For our purposes, say these two pieces of steel. Now this isn't a pretty weld, this is just something I picked up. In order to get these two pieces to stick together, as you can see there's two angle pieces to make one square piece, you have to melt the material. Granted, there is some filler material as well, but in essence, all the steel, all the metal is melting. And when it's no longer hot, it cools and becomes a solid again. My question is, if we have a leak that I cannot detect, I literally sprayed a whole bunch of soap everywhere, on the rim, on the tire, on the sidewalls, on the, everywhere. I wonder, you guys see where I'm going with this? I wonder if I take the back tire and put it on the front, and take the front tire and put it on the back, and see if a certain driving maneuver fixes that tire. The maneuver I'm speaking of is a burnout. Let me put this tire on and explain a little bit about science. Let's say you were 50 miles away from home, or maybe even 100 miles away from home, you had a small leak in your tire, so an idea pops into your head, hey, maybe I should do a burnout. A burnout increases tire temperature, which then provides more pressure or more PSI in the tire. Let's say you had a small leak around the rim or the bead of the tire. Maybe a burnout would give it an extra little kick and maybe tighten the tire down to the rim once your tire re-grips the ground after your burnout or the road. But 3D machines have a nice vehicle. I don't want to screw it up by doing a burnout. Well, then maybe this isn't for you. This is just a stupid test I came up with. Well, I'm currently coming up with. But my theory is not only will the tire heat up and add PSI or pressure in the tire, if I do a long enough burnout, maybe the rubber will actually melt and seal that hole or that leak. What do you guys think? Do you think it'll work or do you think it'll be a bust? I think I'm right on the fence, maybe a little closer to the it might work side. Because hey, let's face it, some crazy ideas just work. There is currently 41 pounds in this tire. And 45 pounds in this tire. For the purpose of this video, all the tires have been inflated so that they're all 45 PSI. Like I said, the max these tires take are 50. And then we are going to test my theory. Everything is locked and loaded. I have 150 miles exactly on my dash. I'm taking it nice and easy. I'm not going crazy. I'm just driving how I would if I were in a regular car or a regular truck. We've gone our first mile. I think we'll stop at mile two. On the one that has the leak, we have 46 PSI, exactly 46 PSI. On the other rear tire, we have 45 and a half. So the tire pressure has already gone up. So just from regular driving, the air pressure has gone up. Now this is a very slow leak, very slow. It takes a full day in order for the tire to go soft, not flat, soft. It drops from around 45 pounds down to 20 pounds. It's been exactly 7 miles. The tire with the leak has 47 and a half pounds. The other one that doesn't have a leak or has never given me a problem is still at 45 and a half. So that side isn't heating up as fast as this side, which is a little confusing to me at this point in time. It's been 12 miles. Checking the tire pressure again. 47 and a half, 46. That one finally went up a little bit. This one stayed the same. Now we're gonna try a burnout because what I'm doing right now isn't going to fix it in any way. This is what I've been doing, and that's what caused the tire to leak. So
I After the burnout, we have 48 pounds and 46 and a half pounds.
If fixing a flat tire was as easy as driving around, nobody would have flat tires. I understand there are a lot of variables when doing something like this. But two things I have discovered. One, burnouts increase tire pressure, which wasn't that big of a surprise. But the big surprise was the tire with the leak actually gained more PSI than the tire that hasn't given me any issues.
This is the tire 25 hours later. Absolutely no problem. No sign of a leak. It has now been 40 hours. Still no sign of a leak or low pressure.